Sound rolling. Walking, take two.
Action. I'm rolling.
Sound rolling.
Country lane, reverse shot, take 4B. Action.
I reckon there are certain lines that you can come in really close. And I'd be like backing off, you know, because you're at the same time you're supposed to be 17 and you're very cocky for a 17-year-old.
I feel like I need to be a bit more playful with it. I think I'm sounding a bit more like someone's mum.
Well, you got that breadth to get to when it comes to the argument. You're 22 years later. I've had enough of this. Like, you are a lady. You know, you've totally changed. But you're 17. Now, so I think you're a little bit flattered.
Just trying to remember the lines, to be honest. But
should we do it again? I've got my pieces of paper here. And actually, it should just flow, like, with no breaks and be really clear. The other thing is that I'm going to have to stand in the background and do this when it's your line, Izzy. And you're not going to hear my lines, which is going to be even harder for you, because my lines give you cues like, I'll pay you for your trouble, like, which reminds you, don't bring trouble to me door. I started working with you, JDef, years back in the day, and seen you do some amazing music over the years.
Thank you. You're very kind.
Your skills are outstanding. Just fill us in a little bit on what you've been up to, really, over decades.
Well, I don't even want to put a number on that, because it's scary how long we've known each other.
Yeah.
And, you know, we've sort of like, I think we've always hit it off from day one.
Yeah.
Always had a laugh.
Definitely.
We've got very serious at times about certain issues, you know, but we've been there, we've talked about things, so it's like, I feel like I know you like a brother.
We're part of an alternative family of artists from back in the day across Manchester that were really politically bonded, you know.
I'm a musician, composed music for theatre, done some film, done radio, played in bands for too many years. I'm not going to say how many years I've been doing anything.
Multi-skilled, and the crossovers we've got as well of all of our different skills coming together is what's going to be really exciting on this project.
Yeah, it is. I think that's what keeps us young, because we're constantly evolving. We don't do the same thing every day.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And some people ask me, what drives you? I think, that's that. I'm interested. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm working with Joey on Saturday. I'm working with Clive. It's interesting. We're going to work hard, but I know we're going to have a laugh as well.
Yeah, we are.
Action!
What I'll do is I'll film you walking past this way, yeah?
So come back the other way?
Yeah, so you sort of stand there and then walk past.
All right.
Nice.
I mean, I know you, I know Clive. I'll be bringing all the kit, you know, boom and everything, like.
Brilliant.
And it's like,
it's these networks and cycles, and it's all about sharing the love as well, really, isn't it, at the end of the day?
Oh, yeah, totally. You know what I mean? And it's interesting to see how we've all evolved, you know what I mean? Because it's like, you know, I remember meeting you and I was thinking, wow, this person's got something to say, you know what I mean? I can't wait to hear it. And I think that's the excitement, isn't it? It's like, I think we were lucky in the environment that we were able to operate when we were younger. You know what I mean?
Politics and finance, since the Conservatives have got in, has totally changed.
Totally.
Closing the green rooms, I still miss.
The scenes we shooted on Saturday.
Yeah.
There's two of you, yeah?
There's two sections of, it's mainly just going to be Izzy talking, leaving space for me on stage to respond to her live.
So I'll only ever be recording one person at a time.
That's it. So I'll be, you've seen shows before where I speak to my inner self or my drag queen or whatever. So this time it'll be actually Izzy on the farm. So, because I'm Harry Stokes' ghost from 200 years ago, I'm kind of flashing back in time to tell the story of my life.
But will you be feeding her lines?
Her eyes will be looking right at camera, which will be me. So I'll be stood behind camera going, and then on the last line, I'll be doing that. And she won't be able to hear me. So it'll be harder for her to get the cues from me. She can't really look at me because it doesn't, you know.
Yeah.
I'm just going to have to stand right and put my hand up. Above Clive's head or either side and just go like
got you. I'm bringing a proper, you know, one of those blimp shields and a long boom.
Cool.
So we should, I can't guarantee cutting out all the wind, but we should be able to. I'm looking forward to it. Day out, what more could you ask for?
Get your kit out, Jay.
You're always asking me that.
Oh, look at that big boom.
Right, so I've got this boom, and then all the recording will be done on this device.
Mm.
And it's just XLRs in. The light starts changing.
That's it. And that's why I wanted to do the film of the farm first, and then the running away stuff kind of later, because that, it doesn't matter if the light is different for that. Just bring everything, and we'll see what works. Is that...
Yes.
I'm really looking forward to it, and we're all going to share some amazing skills with each other. So thank you in advance, and I'll see you soon.
I don't need to put it on my phone, you know. Might be easier on my phone. I'll just do it on here. See how this works.
No, copy it to your phone.
Yeah, it's just my water bottle. Yeah, I don't just see it on my phone or on here. I'll do it on my phone. And then I could go like this. No, actually, I'll just do it on here. I'll just do it on here. It's fine. We'll see.
Right.
Are we doing the farm one first?
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, Anne. She worked first. And just knew as soon as... Right, start again. Do not focus.
Okay, let's go. Three, two, one.
Sound rolling. Pigpen, take three. Action.
Oh, Anne. She went first. I just knew when I saw her mucking out that pigpen. Just froze. Couldn't get a word out of me. She must have thought I was a complete numbskull.
He just stood there, gawping. The blockheaded dumbass.
The lads jostle me all week, and I'm a tongue-tied and crimson every time I set eyes on him.
I thought he was as thick as two short planks.
Till I built spine up to speak to her.
I brought the lads the dinner over as usual.
With the day we finished on job on Lambingcroft, so I knew I need to grow a pair and speak to her the night before we left, like... thanks again for grub. You've taken right good care of us, lads. I just wanted to say how much I appreciate it, like.
Why, thank you, Mr. Stokes.
You just milking and cleaning and cooking and trading, like, all night and day.
That's nice for you to take an interest in all I do round here. I'm always in the shadows, unless something goes amiss. And then I cop it.
they wouldn't run this place without you.
Oh, a bricky and a charmer, ain't we? Now you've found your tongue. Boot licking will get you nowhere, Henry Stokes.
we've nearly barely spoke. Me being so forward, like, with flattery is just really hard to find words.
I might be a country girl, but I wasn't born yesterday. I've no idle time to talk to you. So you best get on your way and let me do the same.
I could muck out that pig pen tonight after lights out if you join me and tell me how to run the place, like. I'd pay for your trouble.
I'd thank you to keep trouble away from this door. I work for me bread. I should report you. And you all leave with no wages.
I didn't mean to offend. I just wanted to pay you to school me, like. I can't even write my name. I didn't mean nothing by it.
Well, When you're done for day and you muck out the pig pen, you'll be lucky if I come back to see if you're still breathing.
Hi, my name is Joe Rose. I've been making music for over 20 years in Manchester. I'm a multi-instrumentalist. I've worked as both an engineer and a producer for various acts. I'm working in two bands at the moment. But for the Harry Stokes project, the track has evolved into something that's been using largely samples to evoke a place of scene and setting. In this instance, church bells for the scene in which Harry and Anne are married. I've also been recording vocal tracks, some of which have been recorded remotely. All these can be mixed together to create a bounce which can actually be used in the play. I've really enjoyed working with this project so far. I'm looking forward to introduce new songs with new artists, working across multiple different platforms and seeing how it all evolves. I'm very much on board with Joey's politics and the ethical reasoning behind this play. It's been a great deal of fun, and I expect it to be more so as it progresses.
Anne, we're clever.
It's true. I'd learned some tricks with pen and ink a long way.
She blotted out my name and put Henry on our marriage certificate.
I spelt Stokes with no A. It is so much more refined.
And then she crosses out a middle name.
Well, I never liked it.
No one will ever be able to track us down now, even if they wanted to, eh?
Now you should always be known as Harry, the hero of Manchester, and I shall be secretary, and we'll build the biggest brick business to make us all rich.
This last me most interested in. If we're running away from the church going, oh my God, we can be almost chatting with each other without the camera hearing us, you know, we can be on a moving shot down the side of the canal or whatever. And we need, I think it needs to be in the first person, like we're talking to each other in the way it's written.
Yeah.
So I could say something like, oh God, Anne, you were just so clever. And you could be like, yeah, you are right, you know. I have learned many tricks with my pen. You know, we could change that.
So, like, we're telling the story together to the audience, because then that would still work and it would still be, like, in first person.
I just go, if we've pulled it off and we've actually got married and we've got out of the church and we've found whatever witnesses we've managed to grab off the street, we're going to be so excited. I reckon we just do this, like, you know, when we're well out of hearing view of the church and we're on our way, we're like, oh my God, I can't believe we just did this. And it's just like, I can't even write my name. Like,
I think the last three lines would be fine to stay as they are, because that sounds like we're talking to each other anyway. And then you could just start with, you were so clever then. And then I learned some tricks along the way. And then you're like, and when you blotted out my name and you wrote Henry. And I was like, well, you know, it's just like going over what's just happened and you're like,
no one will ever track us down now, not even if they wanted to.
Hey. No. And you should always be known as Harry, the hero of Manchester, and I shall be your secretary and we'll build the biggest brick business to make us all rich.
Oh, and you crossed your middle name out.
Well, I've never liked it.
Because it was not refined enough.
Oh, Anne.
She was the first. So once we've done our traditional shoot, and John the photographer is from a different photography point of view, John has a much more... I mean, he's got an amazing creative eye, and some of the kind of foregrounding shots of us like running away from the farm, et cetera, will be like really, really beautiful. We just gelled straight away. Really amazing to work with you.
I appreciate that.
You're clearly very experienced. You really know what you're doing. All the publicity images, they're just so strong, John. I just wanted to ask you, like, what your favourite photographs are out of the thousands that we took, just that spring off the top of your head?
So the rolling hills, the atmosphere, you could just see everybody was in a good mood to up on the peaks with that light, with the guys that were working together. I thought as a team effort was going to be a success, whatever happened. The reason, not because of the photos, more the atmosphere and how everybody's gelling together immediately. We all had a bit of a laugh and we knew what we wanted. And there was a professional attitude to everybody.
Yeah, I mean, we kind of had that on the farm shoot as well, yeah. Didn't we? What are the shots that stand out for me the most? Just those certain magical ones. And a good photographer can be invisible almost on a shoot and kind of give very small directorial suggestions when needed. But in terms of perspective, the height, the way that you would change your lenses, or, you know, the position from where you were shooting, you know, all those things are what you're talking about, how you could focus on your professionality and I could focus on my characterization type of thing, and my body language and so on and so on. So
here's a question back on you. What is your favorite photo that I've taken?
Those beautiful moments sometimes between me and Anne, some stunning shots of the two of us in the outside the church, because we were talking about that, getting that light, and you nailed it.
I didn't really have to direct you guys. I just wanted you to be yourselves, do your part, and I would then be able to move around in the background, trying not to step on the odd twig or whatever, and I could nail the shot because I knew you knew your job. In a weird way, it was just so refreshing to work with a group that I didn't have to be both a director and a photographer. I could just be a photographer.
Yeah. Rose-tinted, in the countryside, looking into each other's eyes, kind of, you know, falling in love. And then before that, obviously, you and I did.
I loved the canal. I remember clearly you looking at the weather going, oh, what are we going to do? This is awesome.
I was like, you are absolutely bonkers insane.
Yeah.
And you were like, but my camera's waterproof. Like, massive lens. And like spectators as well, of people watching me climb across that lock that was completely soaking wet and so slippy. Guess off the top of your head, how many approximate photos you took throughout the whole Harry shoot?
Between 600 and 800 a shoot. 2 to 2,500 over the overall.
What was it like for you as well? Because you've worked with lots of different types of people, and working with me from the beginning one-on-one, you could tell that I was an actor or a performer or an artist, and so I was working for the camera in a different way than perhaps somebody who wasn't an artist.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, it reminded me very much of, I've worked with quite a few models and trying to get them to pose, etc., and some of them have been a real struggle, and there's one or two that have been really experienced, and you just literally, it's been a minute where they've just gone bang, that's that, bang that, look that, and they just go into character, and they're now, and you can literally sit there and you just go, well, I've booked you for an hour, but 5 minutes later I've got all the shots I need, and it's done.
When we were doing our one-on-one shots, it was a very specific thing for Harry and kind of publicity shots, but it's different when you're kind of on set and there's moments that you can accidentally just capture because people are constantly moving. You know, so there's almost those two binaries and then loads in between of those.
Yeah, well, it's a tapestry, and if you want to make each thread is a part of it, and if you want the right colors.
Me standing above Izzy on the moors with a shot between my legs after we'd just got married, because it's this kind of patriarchal positioning of where almost Harry's masculinity becomes legally validated, and they're just traveling to Manchester to begin that kind of stealth underground life in the big professional city. And it's really metaphorical of the transition that they make over the 22 years from that farm life to who he becomes in the city. And 22 years later, the argument that happens, you know.
Everyone knew their part, knew what they needed to do, and just cracked on. with a bit of a smile, and it was nice to sort of add another string to my bow on this journey. And I'd like to think that we are only starting a journey, because we've done a part of the story, but there's so much to be told. And I'm really proud to be telling the story of a part of the, I guess, of society that's been sort of sidelined, marginalized. This potentially can bring this section of society into the main. And that's really, really important for me.
And when somebody takes your photograph, it makes you feel like you're valid and you're important and you're seen. So yeah. It kind of has all those layers, and the kind of heritage and the archiving of it, and the fact that during the Q&A, your images were beautifully projected as we chatted for like half an hour with the audience. Because of course you've got live photographers taking photographs of me on stage with your photographs behind me.
Yeah.
As well, which is really, must be really interesting for you to see.
Yeah, very much so. Well, that's where my next question was, is what is the next step?
Almost like the way I envisaged a kind of scrim, half semicircle kind of fabric where you can project from the back and from the front. So it's it's more of a surrounding environment than a 2D flat back wall projection, you know, and you can potentially tour with that fabric and obviously interact with other people that are surrounding you in a way that isn't so 2D. I think I'd like to bring more Joey as a human being into Harry in the modern sense, so that there's a lot less kind of traditional play acting and more of a kind of fluidity between Joey and Harry. And stuff that's a bit more kind of surreal and experimental and not so literal, you know? So, yeah, I'm really excited to see where it's going to go. The administration behind even the small grant that we got for this has just been absolutely phenomenally time-consuming. And editing is... I've learned so much video-wise as well, but... You remember when I put my iPhone in that waterproof case and dropped it into the canal?
That was absolutely one of the better things I've seen. I think that was absolutely, you nailed it almost in one, didn't you? It was like one shot that you did, and you,
yeah,
that was brilliant.
It's just a kind of template to give other artists an idea. Because if you imagine that being shot as well professionally,
it looked professional, mate. But I was really, really impressed with that. Just more the coming up with that idea, the concepts, putting it all together as a nice package, bang, worked. Well, impressed with that.
But anyway, yeah, I just wanted to say you were absolutely amazing to work with. You gave so much of your time in kind. You were so generous. You're such a beautiful, beautiful soul and an absolute joy to work with.
Great to work with as well. Things are easy when there's a collaboration like yours. Same with Izzy, same with the other guys. You could see everybody trusted each other, knew what they were doing, and it was just I came back with a real buzz. I think that's the main thing, is you learn and you experience, and the main thing was there was enough there for you to use, and that was brilliant.
There's hundreds that are a genius. There's so many that have to be cut out. It's such a shame. But yeah, I've just been really lucky, got some fantastic footage, so thank you so much, really, and I look forward to working with you again.
Yeah, no, very much so.
Uh, And Mum, have you got now on the table for me again?
Supper went cold hours ago. It's gone to soil collector.
Grateful wench.
What time do you call this to grace me with your presence?
Well before midnight. You give more affection to dog than me.
I've asked you countless times to come home at a decent hour, but you never do.
Why would anyone want to come home to this nagging?
This is no laugh for me. I'm at home, running your business, the house and everything else, while you go get slaughtered down pub.
Burn myself to the bone to provide for you.
You're a brute and a bully.
Just crawl back to whatever filthy gutter you've clambered out of.
I'll never lay a hand on you, but you carry on pushing me, and so help me. Oh, no wonder I keep so long hours down pub.
Oh, so I should be grateful you haven't beaten me black and blue. 22 years I've managed this business. You couldn't afford the pub if it wasn't for me looking after money.
You'll do as you're bidden.
Oh, don't try lording it over me after all I've done for you.
Look, I built my business with my own hands like years before you arrived.
Oh, all by yourself, did you? This ain't what I was promised. You're worse than a jailer and I'm an unpaid slave.
Might as well have helped build this business, but you're still me wife.
You don't own me.
You do wrong and it's me who goes down in court, a prisoner worse than it's my reputation at stake. You'd have me hanged, woman.
Then why don't you behave like an husband instead of gallivanting like an animal with all and sundry?
I'm special police constable with responsibilities. We don't get time to be off with wife. My only break is down the pub.
Oh, poor you. You can't look after your own. Why don't you own anyone else?
Time with the jobs you pile up on me plate. And there's no food on table. Why bother paying your housekeeping, eh?
Oh, so you've got time to drink and flirt all over the shop while I'm supposed to sit here waiting for you?
Oh, you green with all the scandal.
What scandal?
Oh, mixing with those round-eeled women.
Oh, do I now?
Fishwives and tattletale on every corner.
Well, I've got nowt to say.
Pro, cold as a scabby corpse.
Oh, and you're soft with wet brain drowning in rum.
Oh, you never lie with me no more.
Full of bloat, sneering down your nose in your shiny uniform.
At least I'm no old strumpet like chasing rich men for babies.
Oh, you're green jealous. You've taken leave of your senses. Now the streets of Ayres and the whole of Manchester's talking about you.
You know I ain't got means to increase a family.
We had an understanding when we were married.
Can't make you happy. Spite of all the gossip, I've earned an honest reputation, and you're just stashing that money, getting ready to move on. Eh?
I don't have a farthing. Well, I've worked morning, noon and night.
You're led back to that farm with that rich toff next door or one of those lady gentlemen you have over the tea.
Ah, why shouldn't I?
So you make a laughing stock out of me. Why don't you carry on, eh?
Oh, you're an embarrassment. Don't tell me you haven't been to brothels. I've had to scrub the stench out of your clothes afterwards.
So, well, where else am I going to get any affection at? I mean, I've seen you wind up every possible stepping stone to our society, even those female husbands.
I spent long, cold nights hoping you'd be sober and pull me to you. But you always turn away.
Just giving up trying. Eh? I mean, all we left is business gone sour. I can't carry load with all my injuries at my age, dealing with all those cut throats and all the corruption.
Well, speak to me then. Pull me close. Make me feel special again. That's how I was so sweet on you in the first place.
All I know is you don't want to lie with me no more.
Well, no, not like this, I don't. You need to curb your appetite for ale.
No, enough, woman. I'll just go sleep back at the inn and find some food there.
Oh, go then. Slam the door and walk out like you always do. And prove me right.
Right.
Why don't you crawl back to whatever filthy gutter you've crumbled out of?